600 miles west of the Philippines in the Pacific Ocean, lies a remote string of islands.
Palau may just be a bunch of tiny specks in the middle of the ocean, but it's teeming with marine life down there. Millions of jellyfish, up to 100 different shark species. It's known as the Serengeti of the sea. Every day, the reef is full of incredible animal behavior, but there's one event that eclipses them all.
Once a month, thousands of red snapper gather on a remote reef to spawn. The reef is known locally as Shark City, and for good reason.
Of all the reefs they could choose to spawn, why Shark City? It's in some of the most inhospitable water in all of Palau. And these are the mysteries that I really want to understand. I really want to spend as many hours as possible down on that reef during that peak window to really start to build an understanding of this incredible event.
But getting there will be incredibly challenging. Shark City Reef sits on the westernmost edge of Palau. It's at the mercy of huge ocean currents, and it all happens 70 feet beneath the surface. As if that wasn't enough, right now, we're in typhoon season.
Okay, Pat, so we're at the site. Bit of a swell, mate. This is borderline, yeah?
Well, let's give it a shot.
There's an okay-sized ball of snappers just off the side of the boat here.
That's a lot of snapper. They're moving this way.
But the weather and the currents aren't the only things we'll have to contend with.
The bull sharks love this aggregation.
The weather. Looks like we've got a little bit of a gap here. It's suddenly died way down. Still doesn't look very good. But at least for the moment, it's flattened out, so this could be my only chance.
Ready, guys? 3, 2, 1, go!
The plan is to stay down for as long as it takes.
The guys down there, they are going through a workout. They're definitely in for a pretty intense dive.
So the current is ripping now. I'm having to swim really hard against the current.
We've got a 700-foot swim to reach the furthest point of the reef, where the spawning is likely to happen. Small schools of snapper are heading in the same direction. Then, I see something I'll never forget. A mass of fish so dense, it's blocking the light. Thousands of red snapper, tightly packed and towering above me. And more are joining by the minute, surging together. Bull sharks patrol the edges looking for hunting opportunities. They can measure over 11 feet and weigh up to 500 pounds. An oceanic blacktip joins the fray.
Must be a sign it's nearly dinner time.
I try to keep the sharks in vision at all times. But there are a lot now to keep an eye on. We've now been down for over an hour, but I'm not going anywhere until they spawn. Some snapper break off and begin an elaborate dance. I grab Dr. Linfield's camera to measure the scale of the event. Then the spawning erupts. A sole female darts to release her eggs, and the males race to fertilize them. But the water is full of predators. With gaping wide mouths, marauding black snapper come for the eggs.
Oh, they're ruthless. They're just devouring all the eggs.
And the sharks are here to hunt both species of snapper.
It's like fireworks erupting.
Then, as I'm watching the scene unfold, a large bull shark changes direction with a flick of its tail and heads right at me. Beneath me, more sharks cut through the school. But the snapper's survival strategy is clear. This is a numbers game. They can spawn over 100 times a minute, and there are thousands of fish spiraling above me. The water is thick with eggs.
Wow, visibility is terrible now. It's hard to even see through it.
As the snapper begin to thin out, I realize we've been down for over 3 hours. It's time to surface.
There were just blankets of snapper. Sometimes you couldn't see the sun because there were so many fish above. And the aggregation was growing and growing and growing. And then all of a sudden, one bolts off into the deep blue off the edge of the reef and just explodes with eggs all over the place. And then sharks coming in trying to feed at the same time. One got a little bit sidetracking him directly at me. Bit of a tense moment there for a second.
The sheer number of red snapper and eggs means some will always get through. And they choose this remote place for all the reasons that make it so hard for me to dive here. The strong currents sweep their eggs directly out to sea and away from predators.
It's such a rare thing to see. It really is only happening the couple of days before the full moon, in the very limited time right around the sunrise, and in this specific reef right here in Palau. Unbelievable experience to be right in the middle of all that. That was more fish than I've ever seen in one place anywhere in my life.